Consider the time you spend in cars. Short trips, long journeys, traffic jams. What happens to the myriad random thoughts you have as you gaze out of the window? The ideas that combust and tick over in your internal suggestion engine, your subconscious. Well, ideas are energy, and energy never dies. They motor skyward into the imagosphere, revved up with "Are we there yet?" anticipation. Melded together, they form an escape route paved with exhilarating opportunities, an ever-expanding arena of challenges with rewards beyond any earthly aspiration. It's a boulevard of woken dreams, a reality built on fantasy, a place you can put your imagination pedal to the metal in a contest of camaraderie and creativity. Sackfolk, start your cerebral engines, for this is Little Big Planet Karting. The Imagosphere is the energy that binds Little Big Planet and all its moons and satellites together. A force so powerful, even the negativitron could not bend, crack, or deplete it. But it needs a guardian. It needs a caretaker. It needs you. A dyed-in-the-wool Little Big Planetian, an adventurer, a stern, focused, enigmatic hero. Little Big Planet is once again under threat. This time from the greedy, grabbing Horde. The Horde scavenge and collect prizes, materials, and objects, but never use these treasures to create and share. All they want to do is keep, to stash, to hoard. No, Sack Friend, your little legs may be perfectly knitted, but even they are no match for the Horde and their rag and bone racers. This is a battle to be fought in a different arena, a racetrack. You need some wheels, my child. Aha! Commandeer that cart and make it your own. Quickly, young sackling, put the pedal to the metal. We know you'll take this mission seriously. Semi-seriously? Oh, crikey. Anyone for driving lessons? The greedy grabby Horde are a simple bunch, so driving one of their commandeered carts isn't going to be a prob for a clever clog like you. You just need to be shown the basics, and you'll be away faster than a cowpat off a hot, shiny shovel. Quick tour of the controller would be good. Ooh, would you prefer to use the X button or the R2 button to accelerate? Okay, the basics. Press the acceleration button and your cart will move forward. Keep it down if you want to burn wool. You can achieve some pretty exhilarating speeds in this game, so let go of the button if you want to slow down for a corner or stop altogether. The brake button will stop you even quicker if you need a loo break. Once you've stopped, keep that brake button held down if you want to reverse. Steering is done by pushing the left stick left or right, or you can use the directional buttons. Well, if you're happy with the ergonomic comfort of your controller layout, just give the old excellent. You've picked your preferred controller buttons and we can continue. And if you want to go back and alter them at any stage, feel free to do so in the pause menu or the settings menu in your pod. You have to feel 100% comfortable when you're wacky racing. Am I not right, sir? In karting lingo, drifting means taking a corner in a really cool way. It's skidding, but controlled skidding, and saves all the hassle of braking. To drift, Steer the way you want to go in a corner whilst pressing and holding the drift button. The cart turns to the side and skids in a visually pleasing manner, I might add. It's advisable to hold your drift until your tyres ignite. That's a good time to release the drift button and get a satisfying boost. You get my drift? You see, that was a superb bit of drifting, both excellent and excellent. The boost you get is from the positive thinking molecules of the imagosphere igniting in the drift backdraft. The bigger the flame, the bigger the boost. Now, who wants to know how to steer and drift at the same time? You're doing brilliantly with the drifting. Now to drift whilst steering your cart. So this time, press the drift button and steer with the left stick. Remember, DNS, drift and steer. Okay, let's try this drift and steer business again. Hold on. Nailed it! Knew you would. Now you're equipped with another string to your bow. Well, you passed your driving test with all the flying colours of the rainbow. Time to start your weapons training. No, we're not getting bogged down in the logistics and ballistics. We're simply going to show you how to blast suckers off the road. Behold the Weaponator. A serious bit of kit. Drive through it to pick it up. Then you can start collecting weapons. Each time you get one, Sackboy will be holding it, looking tougher than 9-year-old cheese and twice as dangerous. Ooh, nicely collected there, number one. You are now furnished with the Weaponator. It dishes out weapons in what we call RR distribution. RR stands for really random. Press the weapon button to fire. Two words, or some, like your style. Now, let's talk about how to make every shot count. Taking a hit will slow you down and make you lose slight control of your cart, so avoid it if you can. Now we're going to give you what we call a defensive weapon. Defensive weapons are slightly sneaky in that they can be deployed behind you to slow down other racers or destroy incoming weapons fire. If you watch for the incoming weapon icon, you'll see it changes into a shield. This is the exact time to press the weapon button and deploy your defensive weapon. When the icon shows a shield, the defensive weapon will fire backwards to intercept the barrage from the brutes behind. Tailgaters. Now you're firing on all cylinders, you clever sack bombardier, you. Just remember, once you have a weapon, you can make use of it straight away or save it for a more dire situation. You can set the difficulty level of your game, you know. Normal is your bog standard. Congrats! In fact, what the heck? Congratulations. Have the full lot. You've learned so much in such a short time. If I didn't know better, I'd think you were an android. And if you ever forget anything or you want a quick recap, get your sack tushy back here and we'll do the whole bally lot again. I would love that. Your pod really is the business end of a rattling good idea. Use the controller to access your pod computer. Then you can choose games or locate your sack chums. The menu button is your cart key, if you like. Tap it to begin the adventure. Have I told you about our loyalty, bonus, allegiance, reward, tar, muchly, welcome back, have a prezi scheme? No? Oh, it's terrific. You've been to Little Big Planet before, so this is our way of saying a big thanking to you for coming back. You get a completely free bonus sack person costume and complimentary cart. Little Big Planet Karting, where we share the love. Little Big Planet Karting is all about fun, frolic. Let the sack race begin, as it's time for your first foray into Imagic Karting. There are mild perils to be faced in the shape of those pesky hoarders. Scoundrels to a man. They cause a fuss wherever they go with their constant challenges. They think they're so fast in their tacky carts, leaning out of them, gesturing for a race, thumbing their whatever passes for noses at us. We'll show them. The pristine Queen Serene, some old chumblies and some new friends are all waiting to see you take them down a peg or ten. Go on, beat them at their own game. Crazy karting.
Thank you.
Well, aren't you the natural-born kart connoisseur? You certainly put the pedal to the metal there, didn't you? And you hugged those turns like they were favourite teddies. Amazing. If you want to master any level you visited, you can, by all means. Or, if you're ready for new levels of exhilaration, use your left stick to find the next badge and action it. Always remember to keep your peepers out for prize bubbles. They're everywhere nowadays. Under this, on top of that, over here, over there. There's big, big rewards in them thar prize bubbles, so don't let any get away from you.
Bye.
this pod of yours, it's a little plain. It doesn't really reflect your wonderful personality. A dash of discerning decoration, a cascade of crashing colour, a torrent of tactile texture. You get the flipping picture. Use all the stuff you find lying around the tracks to spruce the place up. The back button will take you back to your pod. my dear sack friend, if coconut macaroons, ranging from small to large, were given out as prizes for effort and accomplishment, then you would be awarded one with its own orbit. Crikey, we're nearly running out of this particular planet. Shine on, you crazy knitted diamond. Ooh. See that? The final level badge. It would appear that those invisible temporal ticks that time flies have been at work again. Time flies when you're having fun and all that, because we have reached the final level, in this pocket of the Imagisphere at least. Squillions more out there, but what wonders and delights does this last level have in store? What perils? Do you have the courage and the weaponry for battle game mode, one must ask oneself? What are the moral implications of blasting the Horde off the free-thinking freeway? Let's find out, shall we? Battle.
Thank you.
We knew you were a natural-born little big Planitian the second we clocked you. We knew you'd discover something amazing. But a new planet? Wow! You've knocked our woolly socks off. It might be prudent to re-examine the contents of your pod first, though. There's some gadgets, whatnots, and features there that might come in jolly handy. Just a thought. Don't forget your grappling hook. It's great for grabbing those hard-to-reach prize bubbles. And it can assist you greatly in avoiding those terrible green puddles of anti-imagination. Yuck, that stuff will wreck your cart. The Monster Islands are notorious for it. So think grappling hook, laddie.
We'll be right back.
this challenge has a different dynamic to it, as it's not your average round and roundy circuit type race. No, it's an ongoing waypoint race. The object is to find the next waypoint, presumably as quickly as possible. These are uncharted routes. What wonders do these tracks have to offer, such as prize bubbles? What dangers are there, like ridiculously overpriced tea in the roadside cafes?
Thank you. 또! 아야다 우와! 나 에어 또 아하! 으악! 그럴까요? 이럴까요?
This game incorporates the unaffectionately titled Keep Away mode. Wretched, isn't it? But it serves a purpose. It's your job here to protect huge monster's egg. Those greedy grabby horde are after it, so you need to make good use of your grabinator. You and the other sack folk must hold on to huge monster's egg at all costs. The horde will try to do the same. When you're near the egg, press and hold the grab button to hang on to it. Take a hit while you're in possession and you'll drop it, so lots to remember. Keep up the good work, don't have a panic attack, and brush your teeth. Good stuff.
Thank you.
Horde are up to no good again. They've nabbed Victoria Bathysphere's train to ferry stolen cakes. Cakes they've managed to upgrade to weapons. Exceedingly good weapons, too, so be careful. Get in there and teach them stealing is almost as bad for you as too much confectionery. We're counting on you, Saxter.
Thank you.
Sometimes it'll be necessary to dispense with the formality of gravity and enter the airspace of the imagisphere. It's practically flying. Consider it an overextended leap or a big air moment, as we hardly ever call them. You will still need to control your cart during flight, namely air control. Steer your airborne trolley with the left stick. Big air moments normally occur after letting go of something that's levitated you, or you've gone on a long drive up a short ramp, and there's absolutely no need to worry about the airbag deploying in time during landing because there is no airbag. Problem solved.
We'll be right back.
Is breakfast the most important meal of the day? The greedy, grabbing hoarders seem to think so. The way they're gadding about like hungry sharks at an all-you-can-eat shrimp buffet is quite frightening. It's most hypnotizing. You need to get into the action too before all the food is gone. Remember your table manners? Then forget them. There's no room for social etiquette here.
Ja, fai, shabwaliala de jogri mara. Gagnali swin valapadi yigiri halada da puta iapadi yikigi. Ha ha! Dam waliakade yanada de shufale kadaya. And nabadi wo.
Thank you.
Dam wali ek ade yanada de shu for that kada ya. Shop wali ap wadi handi godium. Yana no be in it, kik kada ya. Ya wad yere boo boo. Yo go go beady de ya. Yo wadi ki waba shu but it ala did it. Ya nabada you get it ala. We'll be right back.
It was dark. Somewhere an owl screamed and a woman hooted in distress. Oh, sorry, in this dress, the one I'm wearing right now. From out of the crypt came the monster, a fiend so fiendish it would win a fiendish competition hands down. It was a P.E. teacher. No, this isn't working. Suffice it to say, there's some zombies faffing about in town. Go and sort it out, would you?
Yada Hudata. Yehawan Ladi Dutana Yonabahoha. Fin ya wordy Higun Mari Hukuna Mode Yoko. Yahi Yamana. Naya Wadara Yamana Yehoa. Yana Ho Naba Yanakiri Yoko. Yabora de Hala Yadidu.
Thank you.
Yini mi yuyu, yabonu bana yara. Yihawan lari du shimla butini tu dren ya tarat. No go ga giga gesu wana ma papa. Yeah, popo.
Ola, abas hoa noma. Vabe uto sogana. Asa lasa pava bara. Mas walo kaza. Las nawa wa. Es la imu malawaba. Lasi lemut mosi lawama. Sati abala masti guaro. Asti iti wala. Es la imu.
The control modes in Little Big Planet Karting really keep the excitement levels on max. Take strafe steering mode, for example. This lets your kart go sideways left and sideways right as you continue tearing through the race. Use the left stick to do it. The handling reminds me of the old-style arcade games. One hand on the joystick, the other feeding coins into a tiny slot before the countdown ended and you had to start from the beginning. I think I'm getting old.
Es la emu malawaba ella sole tona nova. Abatskamas agasana tomalasa anananama. As lakawamasta maswala kasa. Lastu ele sole tona nova. Alazama tobalaba. Abatskamas agasana tobalasa. Asuvita Yamati is the Ralavana. Asamas es la Imu Malawaba Elasole Tona Nova Abatskamas Agasana Tomalasa Mamasaba Lava Anananama Alasama Tovalava Lasi Lemut es la Imu.
The famous Little Big Planet Imagis physicist pig Albert Feinswine once calculated SOT. That's speed of thought plus F friction equals DD squared. That's dream drag. To put it plainly, he didn't half talk some rubbish, that's why we turned him into sausages. But driving a B2.0 hover cart is fantastic fun, and we've got you one for the next race. Maybe you'd like to name your hover cart in Albert's memory. The bacon sandwich, for example, or the sausage roller.
Wapiti Wap Seesaw! Yeah, we don't want to. Oh? Wow! Wapiti!
Da Wawa!
Whoa, whoa! Indeed, da Wapa Wawa! Wapiti da Seesaw Wap! We did da Wap! What the Wada Wadada! Wow!
Thank you.
In this event, we're introducing the RoboBun Cart, a nifty little vehicle with GBW handling as a standard feature. GBW handling allows the car to bound high into the air for aeronautical jaunts that will enable you to avoid obstacles or other combatants. It's all incredibly scientific, apart from the name GBW, which stands for Giant Bouncy Wouncy. Unbelievable.
Thank you.
Papa T watch seesaw. I'm a D-Don seesaw one. Who did the one? What the 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 We yada, we nana mana wall. When did you? Oh, wow.
We'll be right back.
Whoa! Whoa! Wapa T watch seesaw! Yeah, window button, oh? Wow! Gira! Gialado batatia!
Gialado batatia!
Mata fata portata. Bumba da ba da ba da ba. Party papa papa.
I have two important messages for you. You are about to step into the final tournament against the greedy, grabby horde. But something is not right. We are all sensing a disturbance in the Imagisphere. This angry ripple in the ether is a warning that something huge and powerful is coming for you. Be careful, young sackling. It may be the unraveling of your very woolly being. Oh, and Dave rang. Can you call him back, Tom? Has our sack hero's defiance made the Horde realize that to take without giving is a hollow pursuit? That to create and share, the very ethos of Little Big Planet, is cast in wool and is exactly how one should live a worthy life. So clean out your clutter, you reformed hoarders. Rebuild your craft world in whatever way you see fit. Let imagination be your stallion, and its eclectic clip-clopping leave trails of wonderment in its wake. Not that you could fit a horse in a cart that size. It was a metaphor. I just meant to be imaginative. Do not try and stuff a horse in that cart. I'm serious. Remember the dog in the envelope incident? Learn from that. Yeah.